In this video, we will create a high-end concrete surface material. Again, we will use professionally prepared images to achieve extraordinary results. These textures come from one of the most popular libraries among visualization experts and are made by the company Arroway. We have three images to deal with. First, we will link this folder to our project using Library Manager. This way, these huge images will not be embedded into the document, which will help us keep the document size as low as possible. We already have an empty surface material assigned to the concrete wall that we'll work with. Let's link the image with the file name that ends with D100 to the color channel. 100 indicates that the opacity of this image should be at 100%. Let's make a render to see the progress. For the next step, let's add the image with the file name ending with B005 to the bump channel. 005 indicates that the bump value should be 5. As there's a huge difference in how certain rendering engines deal with bump, this value is informative. Some interpret the value of bump as length, for example 5 millimeters. With CineRender, this value acts more like a percentage. The higher the resolution of your image, the values that you have to define for bump are higher. Therefore, with CineRender, the value of 5 would not make any noticeable change when using such a high-resolution image as such, but a value of 50 will hopefully work out. Let's make another render to see if we're right. Maybe the change is hard to notice. At the same time, the following steps will emphasize the effect of bump, so let's be patient. Please remember the effect of bump should always be subtle, so don't push it to the extreme. Overall, we can say the bump value of 50 did strengthen the rough structure of the concrete. The file ending with S050 and G025 suggests this image goes to the specular channel. We will set 50% for the mix strength as the file name indicates. Also, please set the width and height values to 50 and 100. Under Illumination, let's make sure Model is set to Ore and Nire. For rough surfaces like cloth, sand, concrete, and plaster, we usually use Ore and Nire. For plastics, Fong is better, and for shiny surfaces that need accurate highlights, Blin is more suitable. Let's hit render again and see the results. Well, it's not easy to judge if we're on the right path or not. The concrete became lighter and pale as a result of highlighting the specular channel views, and we lost important details. We must be missing something, so let's stop for a second and think. There's G025 at the end of this file name. What could it mean? G stands for glossiness, and 025 for the value of it. But we have no such channel or property. Well, it seems like we're in big trouble. Okay, time to improvise. Perhaps glossiness may be related to the reflection channel. Let's add this same image to the reflection channel at 25% opacity with mix mode set to multiply and hit render. Okay, now we're completely lost. This concrete is getting worse with every step. The truth is that these images, which are divided file by file into channels, are not specifically meant to be used with CineRender Engine. What else could we do at this point but to cheat and use our first trick? Let's delete the image from the color channel and move it to diffusion. Turning Effect Luminescence and Effect Reflection on. We've set the color channel to 75% and color value to RGB255 each. From now on, 75% of pure white will be the base color of our concrete, and the image in the diffuse channel will lighten and darken the color channel at the same time, depending on the image in the diffuse channel. And here comes the second trick. We push the height of specular over the normal limits up to 200. Also, let's turn off the reflection channel to see what these changes will result in. It's time to face the truth. Let's make a new render. When we compare the first render on the right with the last one on the left, we can see that we made some great progress and our concrete is almost perfect. Is there anything else we can do to push the limits of CineRender and make this concrete astonishing? Sure there is. We'll cheat again and use another trick. In the Render Settings window, under Lens and Filters, there's a Sharpen filter waiting for us. Let's set its value to 20%, render the scene again, and compare it with the first render. Wow, the difference is light years better. Finally, our concrete came out of the darkness. It's alive and it shines. As a result of our hard work, we have a first-class concrete surface material. Can we say that images labeled with D in file name should always go to the diffusion channel? Definitely not. Please watch our other video clip dedicated to the setup of a wood floor material where we use the diffuse image in the color channel. Every image-based concrete requires different adjustments. There's no such thing as a one setting for all. As always, when making a surface material on your own, please make sure to use a proper test scene that's capable of revealing the true nature of a particular material. Please watch our other video clip explaining the importance of a test scene.